Meanwhile, Vladimir Tarasenko, where do you think he plays next season? There were a lot of trade rumors out there a couple of weeks ago. Everything's kind of quiet right now.
It is kind of quiet. And that, this is one situation as distinguished from the Eichel situation. I think it's possible that Tarasenko may remain a St. Louis Blues. I don't say likely to remain, but may remain a St. Louis Blues. This group could certainly use the pop up front. Can Senko get over the way things have kind of gone in the past? I think there still remains a fit for Tarasenko there. But again, this is a situation where half the teams across the league are pressed right up against the cap. Tarasenko has a no-trade clause. Of course, you know, if the situation is that sour, he'd be willing to waive that and perhaps submit a list of teams where he eventually hopes to land. But he takes down a pretty a top-heavy number as well. Eight, I believe, just in terms of the average salary, mm-hmm. average value of the contract. So that's a pretty heavy hit. Here's an interesting wrinkle to this situation. Given the salary cap problems that teams are having, clubs like Seattle, mm-hmm. for instance, have cap space. Do they become an intermediary for a transaction whereby if Tarasenko were to land there in the interim, but eventually go to another team, and Seattle takes on some of that salary, that may provide kind of the recipe for a cap problem on the ultimate acquiring team for a Tarasenko. Yeah. That could be interesting.
Interesting. Cap space, the ultimate luxury in the NHL
right now. And cap space, especially in the present circumstances, cap space is at a premium, no
question. Yeah, and this guy can still certainly score goals with the best of them.
No
Maybe
question.
Some concerns coming off another shoulder injury and another shoulder surgery for a guy like Vladimir Tarasenko. Look what he's done the last 3 years, though. You go back to 2018-2019, put up 68 points in 76 games. 2019-2020, a little banged up there, played just 10 games, 10 points. And then last year, again, late in the season, 24 games, 14 points. But when this guy's healthy, he's still one of the best scorers in the NHL.
Yeah, lots of good hockey left in his game. Assuming health where the shoulder is concerned, assuming he's somewhere near 100%, I'm with you. He could be an impact player.